Welcome to this new video where we'll solve the repeated substring pattern problem. The problem says, we have a string s and we want to know if we can construct it by repeating the same substring multiple times. Is the case for example for the string abcd abcd abcd, because it's just the substring abcd repeated multiple times. But it's not the case for example for the string abc abc cb. The repeated substring can be of size 1 like with this example. The first solution that we may think of is the brute force solution. We just try to multiply each prefix and see if it matches s. For example here, we repeat the prefix of size 1, it doesn't match, the prefix of size 2, ab, it doesn't match, the prefix of size 3, abc, it doesn't match, the prefix of size 4, abcd, it matches, we return true. To know how many times we repeat the prefix, we just divide the length of s by the length of the prefix. In code, we set n as the length of s, then we iterate over the sizes I from 1 to n divided by 2 inclusive. We stop at n by 2 because we cannot have a repeated substring whose size is more than the half of the string. And at each iteration, we make the prefix of size I by extracting the substring from 0 to I. We repeat it n divided by I times as said earlier, and we see if it's equal to s. If it's the case, we return true. But the problem with this solution is that it's slow. The loop is doing n by 2 iterations, and at each iteration, we have n for repeating the prefix and n for comparing with s. The time complexity is O of n squared, where n is the length of the input string. But fortunately, we have more optimized solutions. The second solution is based on finding the length of the longest proper prefix that is also a suffix. A proper prefix of s is a string whose s starts with and that is different from s. To check if a string is a repeated substring, we have to check if n, the length of s, is a multiple of n minus k, where k is the length of the longest proper prefix that is also a suffix. N has to be different from 0. Okay, now you have two questions in your head, why and how? You have to know that if we take the substring that is before the longest proper suffix that is also a prefix and we keep repeating it, at some point we will reach the end of the string. For example, in this one, the longest proper suffix that is also a prefix is abcdab, and the substring before it is abcd. We keep repeating it, abcd, 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 and you can see that we reach the end of the string. But they don't match, the string is not a repeated substring because the length of s, which is 10, is not a multiple of 4, the size of abcd. So after finding the longest proper prefix suffix, we subtract its length from n and n has to be a multiple of the result. Let me show you an example where it works. We have abcd abcd abcd, the longest proper prefix suffix is abcd abcd, and the remaining part is abcd. And if we keep repeating it, abcd, 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 we reach the end of s, but this time they match, so s is a repeated substring. Why? Because 12, which is the length of s, is a multiple of 12 minus 8, which is 4, the length of the substring that is outside of the longest proper prefix suffix. It has to be a multiple because the number of repetitions is an integer, it cannot be 3.25 or something like that for example. Now you know why does this method work, but you still need to know how to get the length of the longest proper prefix suffix. To do so, we use the technique we use in the KMP algorithm. We generate the LPS array, where LPS of I represents the length of the LPS of the string that ends at the index I inclusive. To fill it, we use two pointers I and j initialized to 1 and 0 respectively. Then while I didn't reach the end of the string, if s of I and s of j are equal, we increment g, we put it in LPS of I, and we increment I. Else if they don't match but g is greater than 0, g goes back to LPS of g minus 1, so we start again from the end of the prefix. Else if it's already equal to 0, we just put 0 in LPS of I, and we increment I. With our example, this is how it gets filled. Now the length of the LPS of s is in the last cell, it's 8. Now we check the conditions, knowing that n is 12 and k is 8. 8 is greater than 0 and 12 is a multiple of 12 minus 8, so our string is a repeated substring. And this solution has an O of n time complexity, the cost of getting the LPS array. This solution is efficient, but we also have another one. You have to know that a repeated substring is a non-trivial rotation of itself. For example, if we have ABCD 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 and we rotate it by some characters, we get ABCD 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 again. So it's a repeated substring. This is why in this solution, we just need to check if S is a non-trivial rotation of itself. To check if a string B is a non-trivial rotation of a string A, we concatenate A to itself, we remove the first and last character, and now we need to find B inside. And we will use this technique for our problem. We want to check if S is a non-trivial rotation of itself, so we concatenate S to itself, we remove the first and last character, and we search for S inside. Because in our case, S is both A and B. I can even show you the proof for this method. If we assume that S is a repeated substring, then it's equal to P times K, where P is the substring that is being repeated and K the number of repetitions. So if we concatenate S with itself, we get S plus S, which is PK plus PK. Now if we remove the first and last character of S plus S, let's name it uppercase S, we get P without the first character, plus P times K minus 1, plus P times K minus 1, plus P without the last character. P times K minus 1 plus P times K minus 1 becomes P times 2K minus 2. Remember that S is P times K, so if it's not a repeated substring, then K is 1. By replacing it in our expression, we get S without the first character plus S without the last character. Because 2 minus 2 is 0, we deduce that we can't find S in uppercase S. But if K is greater than 1, then 2K minus 2 is not equal to 0. Let's name it uppercase K, knowing that uppercase K is always greater than or equal to lowercase k. And because uppercase K is greater than or equal to lowercase k, then P times uppercase K is P times lowercase k plus P times uppercase K minus lowercase k. And we know that P times lowercase k is S, so we can find S in uppercase S. We deduce that when S is a repeated substring, we can find it in S plus S without the first and last character, and when it's not, we cannot find it. So in code, we just return that S is in S plus S without the first and last character. And by using an efficient string search and algorithm, we get an O of n time complexity. I hope that you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.